Dear students, good afternoon all of you. I am Dr. D.S. Murthy, Assistant Professor of Microbiology, Usman Medical College, Hyderabad. Today, we will start some of the general bacteriology sessions. I will discuss about culture media and culture methods today. Please listen carefully. If you have any doubts, you can interact. Okay? Why should we do culture? What is the need for culture? One is to isolate the bacteria in pure culture, pure form. Suppose from the patient samples, you want to isolate the bacteria in pure form and demonstrate their properties. You want to show the, for example, Staphylococcus aegis bacterium. It has so and so features for demonstrating its properties, and also obtain sufficient growth for preparation of antigens. For example, you have to do certain tests like agglutination tests. For that, you require some amount of antigen. To get that antigen, you have to have the bacteria in pure culture form. And typing of bacterial isolates. When you want to do certain typing methods, bacteriophage typing, bacteriocin typing, that we will discuss under bacterial taxonomy. And antibiotic sensitivity. For example, you want to treat a patient. To which antibiotics the bacterium is sensitive to which antibiotics the patient is cured. For that, you have to do a test called antibiotic sensitivity testing and estimate viable counts. How many bacteria are living in a particular sample? Living bacteria are there in a particular sample. That is called viable count. You know, bacterial counts are two varieties, total count and viable count. Total count includes all bacteria which are killed also. And viable count includes only the bacteria which are living, which are capable of growing, which are capable of multiplying. And maintain stock cultures. Actually, in the microbiology laboratories, we have to maintain stock cultures. So, for example, to show you in the practicals or to give you in the examinations, we have to have a certain bacterial stocks with us. For all these purposes, these are the uses of culture methods or culture media. Okay? Is it clear? With this basic introduction, now we will discuss about different culture media. So, this classification of culture media is based on their consistency. The culture media are the ones where you cultivate the bacteria. For example, you take the sample, you inoculate them, and that inoculation where it is being done is called a culture medium. It supports the growth of the bacteria. It has solid media, semi-solid media, liquid media. Okay, these are based on the consistency. And based on the function or property, they are simple media, enriched media, enrichment broths, or selective media, indicator media, differential media, composite media, transport media. These are the different groups of culture media. These are all very important in the entrance point of view, because sometimes they will ask you a question, which of the following is a selective medium for so and so bacterium? Which of the following is a transport medium for Vibrio cholera? Which of the following is a enriched medium? Which of the following is a enrichment medium? Like that, they will ask you questions in the entrance examinations. So, for that, you should have understand what is the meaning of it and some examples for each one. Okay. Before going to the description of different media, you should know the basic ingredients of the culture media. Agar agar, it is obtained from the seaweed. It is a basic ingredient for almost all the culture media. It is actually a solidifying agent. You know, the medium has to be solidified to appear to put it in the petri dishes. So, agar agar is the one of the important solidifying agent. Before agar agar, what are the solidifying agents used? Potato, cooked starch, all these were the solidifying agents tried before using agar agar. But a person called Ron Hassay, working in the Robert Koch laboratory, introduced agar agar. It was obtained from the seaweeds. So, you should also know certain important properties of agar agar. It is having a melting point at 98 degrees centigrade. And solidifying point at 42 degrees centigrade. If you heat it up to 98 degrees centigrade, it is melt. Then if you cool it down, it gets solidified. And it has no nutritive value. Agar agar has a no nutritive value. It contains only the polysaccharides. the polysaccharides, the okay, the next thing is peptones. The peptones are a mixture of partially digested proteins. The partially digested proteins are peptones, and yeast or meat extract that also provides nutrition to the bacteria. And sodium chloride, you know, salt, sodium chloride is a basic ingredient. It is needed for maintaining the life. It is maintained for the integrity of the cytoplasm. So these are the basic ingredients of any culture media: agar agar, peptone, yeast or sodium chloride. Now what are simple media? These simple media are also called as basal medium. Simple medium or basal medium are same, and most commonly used in the routine laboratories. For routine purposes in the microbiology laboratory, we use the simple media. The example is nutrient broth and nutrient agar. Without these two, no microbiology laboratory will function. Okay. The help of nutrient agar is to identify the colony morphology. We can see clearly the colony morphology, and you can say whether the colony is opaque or translucent or transparent. Okay. So to identify the colony morphology, you should use nutrient agar. Next is enriched media. Here, the enriched media is certain additional substances like blood, serum or egg are added to the basal medium. It is the basal medium plus enriched substances, egg, serum or blood. For example, if you add blood, that is called blood agar. If you add serum, the example is Loeffler serum slope. If you add egg, the example is Dorset egg medium. Blood agar is used for so many organisms to demonstrate hemolytic properties. Loeffler serum slope is used for Corynebacterium diphtheriae. Dorset egg medium is used for tubercle bacilli. If we heat blood agar, that gets converted to chocolate agar. Okay, so these are the important culture enriched media and their uses. What is the difference between blood agar and chocolate agar? Chocolate agar is also an enriched medium, but here blood agar can support the growth of most of the organisms, but some organisms cannot lyse red blood cells by themselves but require certain growth factors from the red blood cells. For example, Haemophilus. Haemophilus requires factor X, factor B, which are present inside the RBC. To support the growth of Haemophilus, you have to use the chocolate agar. You heat the blood agar, that gets converted to chocolate agar. All the cells will be lysed. Hemoglobin will be liberated out. Okay, so there you have to use the chocolate agar. So all these organisms, culture media, support the growth of fastidious organisms. You should also know what is the meaning of fastidious organism. Fastidious means it requires more nutrient requirements, more nutrition it requires. Special requirements will be there. That is called exacting in growth requirements. That is fastidious organism. Okay, Neisseria gonorrhoeae is one of the fastidious organism. Okay, Haemophilus, one of the fastidious organism. They require certain extra nutrition. Staphylococcus is not fastidious. It can grow on simple media. So organisms which cannot grow on simple media or basal media but require certain growth like blood, serum or agar called fastidious organisms. Okay. Now there is one thing called enrichment media. There are some differences between enriched media and enrichment media. Okay. So enriched media is you are adding certain nutrients to the culture media. But enrichment is here you are adding a substance which stimulates the growth of the pathogens, but however it suppresses the growth of the commensals. It is a broth. Okay, enrichment is in the broth, in the liquid medium. Okay, there you are adding certain nutrients, certain chemicals which suppress the growth of commensals. Where you have to use it? When you are expecting commensals. For example, you have a stool sample transported for Vibrio cholera. You want to isolate Vibrio cholera from a stool of a diarrhea patient. In the stool, you also have so many commensals. Stool has so much of normal flora. You have to suppress it. There you have to use the enrichment media. There are some important examples are tetrathionate broth, selenate F broth. These two are used for Salmonella and Shigella. So they will ask you a question. Selenate F broth is used for isolation of ABCD. salmonella. So the following one is enrichment medium: blood agar, chocolate agar, selenate of broth, all of the above. So there you have to tip like this. And alkaline peptone water. Alkaline peptone water is very commonly used enrichment medium. It is for isolation of Vibrio cholerae. So tetrathionate broth, selenate of broth for salmonella and shigella, alkaline peptone water for Vibrio cholerae. Is it clear? Right. Now we have to use a term called selective media. It is also similar to enrichment media, but selective media is a solid one. Enrichment is in the broth, enrichment broth or enrichment media, but selective is on the solid medium. A solid medium where certain chemicals are added to suppress, to inhibit the growth of the commensals, but permit the growth of only the pathogens. That is called selective media. For example, TCBS, TCBS, thiosulfate, citrate, bile sucrose agar. It is for isolation of Vibrio cholerae. Okay. So on the TCBS, you can see in this picture where the Vibrio cholerae appear as yellow colonies. The medium will be in the green color, but Vibrio cholerae will appear as the yellow colonies. Okay. You also can check for fermentation of sucrose also in that medium. But it is basically a selective medium for isolation of Vibrio cholerae from stool samples. Okay. Now there are some other selective media also. You can use Mekankis medium for gram-negative bacteria. Okay, it suppresses growth of certain non-enteric pathogens. LJ medium, Lomistein-Jensen's medium. It is a selective medium for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Wilson and Blair medium, that is a selective medium for Salmonella typhi. And potassium tellurate medium, that is a selective medium for diphtheria bacilli. Okay, so there are important selective media. Mekankis agar is given as example for several types of media. It is given as a indicator media, it is given as a differential media, but these others are very important selective media specific for certain organisms. Okay, thiosulfate citrate bile sucrose agar, Lewinstein Jensen medium, Wilson Blair's medium, potassium tellurate medium. Okay, is it okay? Right. Now we will come to a term called indicator media. You know what is indicator? Indicator is the one, a chemical added when it is showing change in color, when certain reaction is occurring or certain growth is coming. Okay. Here sulfate and Wilson Blair's media for Salmonella typhi. For example, you have seen in the previous picture, Wilson Blair's medium is for Salmonella typhi. It is a selective medium actually. But there you also add some indicator to indicate the HTS production. Salmonella typhi will produce black colonies because of HTS production. So it also is helping as a indicator media. In Mekankis agar, lactose fermenters, non-lactose fermenters. Lactose fermenters will produce pink colonies, non-lactose fermenters will produce pale or colorless colonies. That is also an indicator media. Okay. And Christensen's urease medium. Urease positive organisms, urease negative organisms. Urease positive organisms change the color. It is normally yellow in color. If it is urease positive, it becomes pink in color. So that is also an indicator medium. Okay. So in this picture, you can see the urease medium. The right one is in the pink color where it is positive. The left one is yellow color where it is negative. Okay. So in the Mekankis medium also, you can see different colors and TCBS showing yellow color. For example, the types, it is a selective medium for Vibrio. But not all Vibrios will ferment sucrose. There are several species. So Vibrio cholerae will produce yellow colonies. Some other Vibrios will produce green colonies. Okay. There is one thing called differential media. You will find all these terms very nearer to each other and confusing. Differential media is also a type of indicator media. It helps to differentiate two groups of organisms. Mekankis agar is a differential medium. It is an indicator medium. It is indicating change in color when lactose is fermented. It is also a differential medium. Why? It is differentiating lactose fermenters from non-lactose fermenters. In the same way, blood agar is enriched medium. But it is also a differential medium because it is differentiating hemolytic organisms from non-hemolytic organisms. On blood agar also, in the hemolysis, you will have three types of hemolysis. alpha hemolysis, beta hemolysis, gamma hemolysis. Alpha hemolysis is an incomplete hemolysis. That incomplete hemolysis is produced by Streptococcus pneumoniae and Streptococcus viridans. Okay, complete hemolysis is beta hemolysis. That beta hemolysis is produced by Streptococcus pyogenes. Gamma hemolysis is no hemolysis. That no hemolysis is by streptococci like enterococci, Streptococcus faecalis or Enterococcus faecalis. So these are the three important types of hemolysis. Okay. So in this picture you can see the lactose fermenters in pink and pale, non-lactose fermenters appearing as pale colonies, lactose in pink colonies. Okay. Now there is another thing called composite media. The composite medium is, you have a complex nutrients in that along with certain other biochemical parameters which indicate the properties like H2S production. The one like triple sugar iron agar, this triple sugar iron agar is an important composite medium. Triple sugar iron agar, you can see different tubes there. There are different slants. Actually TSA has a slant, a butt and a slant. A butt. Oh, okay. In the triple sugar iron agar, there is a butt. Okay. So, chai bike lap on a apple. So, triple sugar iron agar has a butt and a slant. Butt is the one appearing at the base, that is about 1 inch in length. There is also a slant. Okay. What you have to do is, you have to inoculate the test bacterium. You isolate the bacterium, inoculate it. How you inoculate? You have to streak on the slope and stab into the butt. You have to inoculate into the butt and also streak on the slope. Then you will observe after incubation. So based on the appearances, what happens is, it has three sugars, glucose, lactose, sucrose, and also an iron indicator. Suppose an organism can produce hydrogen sulfide, okay, it combines with iron in that and produces a black precipitate. So black color will be seen. So it has H2S indicator. It has three sugars, glucose, lactose, sucrose, and also you can see the air production, because you can see as a break in the medium. So because you are able to demonstrate several properties by using a single tube, you call such medium as composite media. Okay. So here you can see in this picture the complete pattern of something. So it has, for example, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It is a non-fermenter. Pseudomonas aeruginosa is a non-fermenter. That means it will not ferment any sugars. Okay. What it will happen? It will change the complete medium to the red color. Usually the medium will be in the red color only. The top slant will be, or the medium remains red. Okay. It is not fermenting any sugars. And Shigella. Shigella ferments only glucose. Salmonella ferments only glucose. When they ferment only the glucose, okay, the butt. So the butt will remain yellow, the slant will turn to red. Okay, that indicates glucose only is fermented. When glucose is fermented, butt will be yellow, slant will be red. When lactose is also fermented, when the lactose or sucrose are also fermented, the complete medium will turn into yellow color. So there are some examples for lactose fermenter. For example, you inoculate Escherichia coli or you inoculate Klebsiella. The complete TSA will be in yellow color, both slant and butt. Okay. So if you see the only complete red color, that is a non-fermenter, example pseudomonas. Non-fermenters which will not ferment any sugars. If you see only butt in yellow, slant in red color, that indicates a glucose fermenter, which is a non-lactose fermenter. It can be Shigella or Salmonella. If you see complete yellow color, that is a lactose or sucrose fermenter. Example Escherichia coli and Klebsiella. If it also will produce gas, you can see the medium is pushed up. In the fourth picture, you can see the medium is pushed up. Okay. So if you see gas production, it will appear as the medium is pushed up, or you can also see a break in the medium. Okay. And if you have an organism which can produce H2S, what are the H2S producing organisms? Examples, Salmonella typhi, Proteus, Proteus mirabilis, it can also produce H2S. Okay. So, if you inoculate such organisms, the medium will turn to black color. So, that indicates H2S production. So, by using a simple or single medium, you can find out all these reactions. Such medium are called composite medium. Example, triple sugar, iron, agar. Okay. Now, another important thing called transport media. These transport media are used when you collect the sample and transport to a distant laboratory. For example, you collect here, the laboratory is about 20 kilometers away, or it is about 60 kilometers, it takes about 1 hour or 2 hours or 3 hours. Sometimes villages, the overnight has to travel. There you have to use a medium called transport media. What is the purpose of transport media? They will not alter anything in the culture media, in the sample. They will not suppress, they will not encourage. They will maintain as it is. The number of the bacteria remain viable as they are in the original sample at the time of collection. Those are called transport media. You should have to know different names of the transport media. Stewart's transport medium is for gonococci. Neisseria gonorrhoeae or gonococci is transported in the Stewart's transport medium. The another use of this transport medium is when you are having a sample containing delicate organisms. For example, gonococci. If you take a sample of gonococci swab from urethra, okay, that gonococci are very fragile. They will die within few minutes if they are exposed to dryness. Suppose the sample comes to the laboratory, you test it, you say it is negative. To avoid that, one is to maintain the viability of the organisms for a longer time, and to avoid death of the delicate organisms, you are using the transport media. Stewart's transport medium for gonococci. Buffered glycerol saline for enteric bacilli, and for vibrios there are different types of transport media. Venkatraman Ramakrishnan medium, Carey Blair's medium if these are not available, autoclaved sea water. If you are in Nellore or some coastal area, you can transport even in the autoclaved a sterile sea water also. You can put still sample and transport it. So these are the different examples for transport media. Stewart's transport, sometimes they will ask, Stewart's transport medium is used for gonococci, vibrio, E. coli, salmonella. Like that they will ask. Are the transport medium used for transport of vibrio cholera is Venkatraman Ramakrishnan medium, Wilson Blair's medium, TCBS. You will get confused because you know TCBS is for vibrio. But TCBS, what is that TCBS? It is a selective medium, it is not a transport medium. So to avoid that confusion, you should think clearly. Okay. So these are the different examples for transport media. Now there is some other term called complex media, which contain additional nutrients other than simple media. All are complex media. So many examples are discussed so far are actually complex media. Another thing is defined media. You know exactly what is present in the culture medium. Okay. For example, use Pepton water. You have 1% peptone plus 0.5% sodium chloride, nothing else. You know exact definition, exact content in the culture medium, that is called defined media. For example, if you say yeast extract you are adding, you don't know what it has, you know yeast extract is there, but you don't know what chemicals are there in the yeast extract. It has so many non-specific things. You cannot call them as defined media. Defined media is, you should know exact empirical nature of the culture medium. Okay. Now there is another thing called anaerobic media. So far we have discussed all the aerobic culture media. Some of them can also be used for cultivation of anaerobes. We'll discuss anaerobic culture methods after some slides. But some media are intrinsically help as anaerobic culture media. For example, Robertson cooked meat medium and thioglycolate medium. These two are supporting the growth of anaerobes. You know what are anaerobes? They cannot survive in the presence of oxygen. So these two media have such environment wherein they can support the growth of anaerobes. Okay. Thioglycolate medium is an anaerobic culture medium. Robertson cooked medium is an anaerobic culture medium. There are sugar media also. That medium contains sugar in addition to peptone. For example, you want to test certain biochemical reactions, whether the organism permits glucose, lactose or sucrose, you have to use the sugar media. Okay. So media contains 1% of the sugar in peptone water, 1% of the sugar along with the peptone water, that is the sugar medium. And you should also know a small term called His serum sugars. His serum sugars are used for Escherichia coli, diphtheria, something like that. His serum sugars are the sugar media along with serum added to it. These are supporting for the growth and biochemical testing of organisms like Corynebacterium, diphtheria. Okay, these are His serum sugars. And these sugar media will contain a small tube called Durham's tube. A small inverted tube is kept in the culture medium, that is called Durham's tube. What is the purpose of Durham's tube? I think you can see in this picture, you also can see a small inverted tube in the sugar media. Okay, so that inverted test tube, inverted tube is called Durham's tube. In the fluid, if there is any gas production, for example, some bacteria will also produce gas. Okay. So Escherichia coli and Klebsiella, when they ferment glucose, lactose or sucrose, they can produce gas. To detect that gas production, you can use the Durham's tubes. In the Durham's tubes, the gas will appear as a air bubble. Okay. Durham's tube is the small inverted tube kept in the sugar media for detection of gas production. Okay. Now we already discussed it, but just to revise, what are fastidious organisms that require either a large number of growth factors or must be supplied with very specific ones are referred to as the fastidious organisms. Gonococci, Haemophilus, they require, Haemophilus requires factor X, factor B, something like that. And media commonly used to grow fastidious bacteria are chocolate agar. Haemophilus, we use chocolate agar only. Because the RBC are lysed, all the contents of the RBC are liberated out. Okay. And it is for Haemophilus as well as for gonococci. Chocolate agar supports the growth of gonococci and Haemophilus. Blood agar may not support them. Even if you want to see the growth of on blood agar, it will take longer time and you will see only small colonies. But if you use chocolate agar, you will see good growth of Haemophilus and gonococci. Okay. Both of them are non-hemolytic but require free hemoglobin. Once the RBC is lysed, hemoglobin is liberated along with growth factors. The another one is Thayer Martin or New York City agars, where they are used. Where to use Thayer Martin agar? Where to use New York City agar? They are used to grow Neisseria obtained from body areas where you expect some normal flora, commensals. And both are chocolate agars, say varieties of chocolate agars. Okay, and they contain also the antibiotics. They are made selective. For example, if you add some antibiotic to chocolate agar, it becomes selective. Potassium tellurate is added to chocolate agar. You call it as potassium tellurate agar for Corynebacterium diphtheriae. If it is potassium tellurate is not added, it is chocolate agar for gonococci. Like that. You add one ingredient after another. And often the genetic probes are used instead of cultures for diagnosis of gonorrhea, because nowadays this is the latest technique for diagnosis of gonorrhea, because cultures may take longer time. Okay. Now there is one more medium called Regan Lowy and Bordet Jengu Agars. These two culture media are for Bordetella pestis. Sometimes see the question carefully. Bordet Jengu medium is used for something like that, they will ask. Bordet Bordetella. Or sometimes whooping cough also will give. If you know which organism causes whooping cough, you can write that medium. For example, a sample taken from a case of whooping cough, which of the following is the ideal selecting medium for it? Chocolate agar, Bordet Jengu medium, something like that. Okay. For that, you should have a list of organisms and diseases caused by them. Easily you can write. Okay. Don't jump to conclusions when you are attempting answers. Just see the question carefully. That question itself many times contains some hint. Okay. And this rapid non-culture methods are replacing cultures nowadays. This is just to add up. But you should know what are the different culture media for Bordetella. But you should also know that cultures are being less commonly used for several pathogens, which are difficult to cultivate. Okay. Now there is another thing, thiosulfate citrate bile salt sucrose agar. Very use for Vibrio. It is alkaline medium. Actually, pH is very high. No organism, no other bacteria will grow at that high pH. So Vibrios, which can survive at high alkaline pH, can grow in this medium. Okay. And buffered charcoal yeast extract agar, BCYE agar, is a medium used for isolation of Legionella. BCYE agar, that is buffered charcoal yeast extract agar, the name itself tells what it has. It is buffered culture medium having charcoal and yeast extract. Okay. It contains iron 16 plus charcoal. These are the ingredients of the BCYE agar. Okay. Sometimes they will also tell you the following one is not an ingredient of this so and so medium. PLET medium for anthrax. Polymyxin, lysine, something like that they will give. PLET agar, EDTA, amnopterin. Okay. These are the components of PLET medium, which is not there in PLET medium. These things we will discuss when you are discussing about anthrax. But you should know some of the media and their key ingredients. Okay. Then Lewistin Jensen agar. Where do you use it? You use it for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And here these are for Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Nowadays we are using also the liquid media. For example, Middlebrooks medium, Middlebrooks broth, that is for cultivation of tubercle bacilli for rapid growth. If you use LJ medium for tuberculosis, it takes about 6 weeks. The average is 3 to 6 weeks. So, you cannot wait that long. So, if you use the liquid media, Middlebrooks medium, you can get the rapid identification, rapid culture. Okay. Some other bacteriological media, charcoal yeast extract agar, we discussed buffered Legionella, chocolate agar for Haemophilus and Neisseria, New York City or Thayer Martin media for Neisseria, and Lewistin Jensen's medium and Middlebrooks medium for Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Regan Lowy medium for Bordetella, and thiosulfate citrate bile sucrose agar or alkaline peptone water for alkaline medium for Vibrio cholera. You should have a list of all these media and also the organisms that are used for which they are used. You prepare a list. It is very easy. Make one page list of the culture media where they are used. Finish. You just see them often, it is very easy to recollect. Saborodextrose agar, it is for cultivation of fungi. It supports the growth of candida and also the growth of filamentous fungi. And low pH, it has low pH. TCBS has high pH. It supports the growth of Vibrio. This is having low pH. It supports the growth of fungi. But most pathogens require a pH of, what pH they will require? 7. They will grow around 7. But when, if you reduce the pH, the bacteria cannot grow in this medium. That's why you can use it as a selective medium for fungi, because it is avoiding the growth of bacteria because of its low pH. Second is, it has high concentration of glucose or maltose. Sometimes you can also add antibacterial agents like chloramphenicol and gentamicin. These are also can be added. Okay, that can be a selective Sabrad-Sagar. Sabrad-Sagar with antibiotics. You can add chlorhexidine also. That is called Sabrad-Dextrosegar with actidion. That is for selective cultivation of dermatophytes. Now, what are dermatophytes? The fungi that infect the skin. Those are dermatophytes. If you want to cultivate dermatophytes, you have to use SDA with actidion. If you want to cultivate fungi, you can use SDA with antibiotics. Because antibiotics will not prevent fungi from growing. They will only stop bacteria. Okay? So, because of these reasons, Sabrad-Dextrosegar is not permitting the growth of the bacteria. Okay. Now, coming to oxygen requirements. How do you classify the bacteria? Based on oxygen requirements. Some bacteria are called obligate aerobes. They require the oxygen. Without oxygen, they cannot survive. They are called obligate aerobes. Some bacteria are strict anaerobes. They will die on exposure to oxygen. They are called obligate anaerobes. Some viamedia bacteria are also there. Those are called facultative anaerobes. They can survive if there is oxygen. They can survive even without oxygen. They are called facultative anaerobes. Some anaerobes are actually anaerobes, but also they can tolerate some amount of oxygen. Those are called tolerant anaerobes. When we discuss systemic bacteriology, we will come across these terms. Obligate aerobes, obligate anaerobes, aerotolerant anaerobes, facultative anaerobes. One more group is called microaerophilic organisms. When there is a reduced oxygen tension, they will grow better. Those are called microaerophilic organisms. For example, Helicobacter pylori. Some organisms are capnophilic. Capnophilic means they grow better if you add carbon dioxide. Okay, 5% carbon dioxide, they grow better. For example, gonococci. Okay, so these are capnophilic organisms. This already we discussed. Okay, microaerophils we already discussed. Now come to thioglycolate medium. Why I told about oxygen requirements is you can use thioglycolate medium. Previously, what we discussed, thioglycolate medium supports the growth of anaerobes. In this same thioglycolate medium, you can cultivate all varieties of oxygen requirements and you can also differentiate them. It is actually a tube containing a column of the culture medium. You stab inoculate the sample or the bacterium into the culture medium. You stab it. Then, if it is aerobe, obligate aerobe, it grows nearer to the oxygen. It grows only at the top. If it is obligate anaerobe, it grows only at the bottom. If it is facultative anaerobe, from middle also it starts growing. So, based on that you can guess whether it is aerobe, anaerobe or facultative anaerobe. Okay. So, like that thioglycolate medium is helpful and it supports growth of all varieties of oxygen requirements. Okay. So, this is different to what we discussed now. Depending on the site of the growth, you can guess whether it is aerobe or anaerobe, something like that. Okay. Now, to isolate the bacterium from a sample, you require a solid culture medium.